Hello everybody. Tonight we're going to do a video a little bit different than what I normally do. Normally do them on just straight CB radios, but we're going to do one on a Stryker 440HP. I like this radio really well. It's got some cool features, and I thought I'd go over with you what it'll do and just what kind of radio it is. So we're going to pull the cases off this thing, and I'm going to give you the tour of it, and we'll go from there. Be right back. Okay, we're back. We've got the cases removed, and let me give you just a quick little tour. One thing that is a little different on this radio, this board right here is a tag board. And what that is, it has your MOSFETs for your high power right up on the edge and the back side of the radio, where normally they would be down here. Now, I'm not sure the exact reason that they decided to do it that way, but they did. Everything you can see right here, this is your connector that takes it straight out to your SO239. Over on this side, as you look right here, this is your Echo talkback board. Over here, this is your channels, and this is also how you would convert this radio. So we're going to show you that in just a second. I got to take this board loose, and then I'll be right back and we'll take a look on how to convert this radio. Okay, we're back. We got that board out of the way so you can see. Now here, this is your channel selector right here. This is your channel selector. Right behind that, if you look right here, and I'm going to zoom in, you see this little jumper? Those of you who work on computers or have worked on computers will recognize that. And you notice there's some pins. Let me get my arm out of the way. Okay, you see it's sitting on the right two pins, and that's basically converted. It'll come from the factory. Let me show you how it comes. Just like this. Okay, you see it on the left? It's on the left. To convert this radio, you simply move it over to the right. Just like that. Now you have a 10 and 11 meter radio. That's pretty simple, wasn't it? I took this board out of the way just so that you guys could see a little better. You don't even have to take that out, but I did. I wanted you to see how easy it was to convert. So we're going to put the board back in. We'll power this on, and we'll see what it does just in the stock configuration, just with it being converted. Be right back with you in just a second. Okay, we've got the radio all powered up. Also got made sure that we've got it on D-band, which is normal 40. As you can see, this is a very pretty radio with all the blue. We've got it on medium setting, but let's take a look and see what kind of wattage we get out of this. What we're going to do is we're going to turn the mic gain all the way down. We're going to check dead key first. That's going to be our primary thing that we want to look at here just right now. So let's go up to the meter. All right. Looks like we got 1.28 watts on low power, and about 10.56 on high. Okay, so now what we want to do is let's see what we've got with some modulation. We're going to put it on low power to start with. Hello audio, 1, 2, 3. About 48.7. Now let's turn it up on high. Audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hello audio. So we've got about 55.5, 55 and a half watts on high. And that's basically stock. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and do some tune-up work on it. We're going to see if we can make this thing do a little bit better than that. So give me a few minutes. I've got to get some stuff done to it, and I'll be back with you just as soon as we get ready to test it again. Okay, we're back, and we've done a little of our tune work that we've done. Well, I'm not going to go into the details on it because it's something that I've kind of developed myself, and some things I share, some things I don't. Sorry about that, guys, but let's see what we've got here. So we're going to go up to the meter. Let me zoom in on this meter a little bit. All right, we've got our power down on low. Let's see what we get out of wattage here. Hello, 1, 2, 3, 4, audio test. Audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, we got 91 watts. 91 watts from about a 2.5-3 watt dead key. Now I'm gonna show you a trick. And this is something for MOSFETs that actually works. I'm gonna turn up my voltage on the power supply. And I've turned it up to about 14.9 volts. Haven't touched the radio, as you've seen. Now what we're going to do, let's go in here and watch this meter again. Same exact settings, same everything. Just raise the voltage, supply voltage. Hello, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, audio test. Audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Look at that, 110.6. MOSFET transistors are power hungry, for lack of a better term. They like higher voltages. The rating on them is sufficient that they will accept that kind of voltage. Now I don't recommend you running your radio at 15 volts, but I just wanted to show you what you can accomplish with one of these radios with just a little bit of modifications. So anyway, guys, this is about as far as we're going to go. I should probably do a little more in depth with it, but at this point I wanted to go through, give you a quick tour of the radio, let you see what it's about, and really wanted to show you what kind of power you could expect to get out of them. Oh, and one other thing before I do that, I want to show you the scope pattern, because I've had a lot of guys give me a little bit of a rash about clip modulation and that type of stuff. So let's take a look. 1, 2, 3, 4, audio 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hello, audio. Let me turn the voltage up one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, audio 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now you can see it's sensitive, and I'm going to put a little bit more carrier in it. Audio test, 1, 2, 3, 4. Hello, audio, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now some guys will probably try to say that that's a lawful distorted pattern, however it's not. Testing this radio on the air, it sounds extremely clean, clear. Everybody loves how it sounds. Even with the high wattage, with the voltage turned up, it still sounds clear. The other thing is that we've accomplished is this radio stays extremely cool, and that's part of the mod that I do that I'm not going to get into. But anyway, guys, what I'll probably do is I'll do another video on the receive section, portion of this radio, as it has a really great receiver, something I shouldn't overlook. But for this video, we're going to call it quits. We're running a little short on time. So I will do another video on the receive section of the Stryker 440. You guys have a great evening. I appreciate you watching. If you need anything, we're at customcbradios.com. Check out our website. We can build about anything you'd like to order. Have a great day.